After testing the charging of iPhone 16 Pro Max today, we will test the performance of iPhone 16. The iPhone 16 has been upgraded with great sincerity. It did not continue to use the old processor of the previous generation, but instead adopted the new A18 chip. Although it cannot catch up with the Pro series, the gap is not that big. However, it still does not have a high refresh rate, and the rear camera is still a dual camera, with the main camera being 48 million pixels. The battery capacity of the iPhone 16 is the lowest among the four models at 3561 mAh. Let's open the box. The connector of the included cable is engraved with Apple A2795 Vietnam. Its length is 1 meter, and it adopts a woven design. ChargerLAB Power ZKM003C shows it doesn't have an eMarker chip. The maximum current is 3 amp. The one we got is a teal version. The frame is made of aluminum alloy, which is different from the titanium alloy texture of the Pro series, and the surface is slightly matte. The USB-C port supports USB 2.0 data transfer specifications. It supports external hard drives but does not support recording videos to external storage or external monitors. It adds a camera controls button which can realize various functions such as exposure depth, zoom, camera styles, tone, etc. through different gestures such as tap, long press, double click, and slide. The performance of the iPhone 16 is similar to that of 16 Pro. Under normal circumstances, the power is between 22 and 23 watts, and it will also prioritize to reach a PDO of 15 volts. The instantaneous peak power can exceed 30 watts and can get a maximum of 34 to 35 watts. It supports the Qi2 charging protocol, and when paired with an older MagSafe charger, the power is no different from other models. Next is the charging compatibility test. Apple chargers above 29 watts can reach 15 volts PDO, which is also the biggest difference between this generation and the previous generation 15 series. It can be seen that the iPhone 16 supports the PD protocol. Except for the influence of the maximum power of the charger, its charging power is about 23 watts. The actual charging power of most third-party chargers is around 23 to 24 watts. Chargers that support the 20 watts PD protocol can reach about 19 watts. The compatibility performance is quite impressive. Next, we'll use the Apple 70 watts charger to fully charge the iPhone 16 and put them into a 25 degrees Celsius thermotank throughout the test. The voltage is around 15 volts at first, and the charging curve can be divided into 5 parts. In the first part, the peak power stayed at 21 watts for the first 16 minutes. Then the power gradually drops to 16 watts, 12 watts, and 7 watts in turn. Meanwhile, the voltage dropped to 5 volts at 55 minutes. The final part begins at 1 hour and 6 minutes. The power slowly drops to almost zero. At about 1 hour and 47 minutes, the phone displays that the battery is fully charged, but charging is still ongoing. It takes 2 hours and 5 minutes to be fully charged. We turn it into another curve. The charger can charge the iPhone 16 to 50% in 26 minutes. And it can reach 80% in 56 minutes, 100% in 2 hours and 5 minutes. The final 20% took longer than the first 80%. The charging speed is not much different from the iPhone 15. We also recorded the highest temperature on the front and back after charging for 10 minutes, 20 minutes, and 30 minutes. After 10 minutes, the maximum temperature on the front is 30.3 degrees Celsius. The back is 31.2 degrees Celsius. After 20 minutes, the maximum temperature on the front increases to 32.1 degrees Celsius. And the back is 32.4 degrees Celsius, and the temperature has risen slightly. After 30 minutes, the maximum temperature on the front drops to 31.1 degrees Celsius. The back is 31.6 degrees Celsius. You can see that except for the upper and lower ends, the temperature of the entire back panel is uniform. The highest temperature is about 32.4 degrees Celsius on the back at 20 minutes. Although the maximum power during the entire temperature test was only 21 watts, the temperature performance was still amazing. Well, that would be all the tests for the iPhone 16. The charging power of iPhone 16 has also been improved, but only limited to the instantaneous peak power, which can reach up to 34 watts. However, the power under normal conditions is still about 23 watts with little change. After testing, it can be charged to 50% in 26 minutes, but it takes 2 hours and 5 minutes to be fully charged. But the problem of heat generation during charging does not exist. The maximum charging heat of 32.4 degrees Celsius can be ignored, which helps to extend the battery life. Okay. That's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you next time. Bye.